We're going to leg. Loree Jon Jones, Mike Sigel, please leg for break.
Our referee, Charlie, you're setting in the background. Well, Loree Jon Jones won the lag to start this match. It didn't make any difference, though, because all the momentum after that belonged to Mike Sigel.
But she can easily break and run four, five, six
brutal
racks in a row.
Look at this.
Mike said it best. I'm brutal on this.
2 feet.
Well, I hit it.
They're both laughing. They were both terrible lags, but Loree Jon won again.
Thought I hit that perfect.
I hit it.
I know. It's slow now.
I noticed Mike said the cloth is slow
now.
Right.
We picked up on it without even hearing Loree Jon Jones say it. And she mentioned it to Mary Strong. I was as tight as a drum. Let's see if she loosens up, tries to get into the rhythm, has some fun with this match now.
She made a ball. She made a ball.
And that's again, a beginning.
Almost scratched there. Now, an eight ball in the professionals, IPT Tour, you make any ball, which she made a ball, a stripe ball, she can pick either solids or stripes. It's her choice. Because when you make a ball on the break, you shouldn't be penalized.
Nine ball.
Nine in the side.
She's shooting the right ball here. The stripes are the right balls to shoot.
That was a better stroke.
She could just start early, come out early, and win a game or two, get up a game or two. I mean, it's so much more confidence she would have.
Oh.
Oh, it's just, she just doesn't have it right now. That's just too bad. She would never have missed that shot.
Now, again, the size of the pockets. These are 4.5. Watch how close. See the difference that you can see here clearly. The traditional size of the pocket is 4.5 or even a hair under 4.5 inches, which means you have to be accurate to make the ball. And if you're off even by a half an inch, you miss. Your opponent is now shooting.
These pockets might be bothering her. You might be right, Kevin. I mean, because she has missed so many shots. It's just not like Loree Jon.
And she has not been on the table long enough. We talk about that period of transition, adjustment to the slower cloth and the tighter
corner
pockets.
Corner.
She hasn't been out there that long to really make a lot of adjustments.
To get into that rhythm.
Right.
Yeah.
Mike has controlled the table completely in set number one. He won 9-2.
But the thing about it is the last three games,
four
he broke and run out.
It's getting
so
late, I guess, right?
He started to open up his game at the end, breaking and run out. So let's see what he can do in this set. He was tight at the beginning, but opened it up the last three games of the last set.
Don't hit it perfect. Oh, that's too good.
Who is he talking to? Anybody that'll listen, I believe. She really don't want to hear that.
Right. It's not that entertaining for Loree Jon Jones.
Six ball.
Voted the greatest living pool player in the world.
He should be.
Three ball in the corner.
Pretty much out of competition for the last 10 years because there was no money in pool. Now with the International Pool Tour, millions of dollars in prize money.
Five ball in the corner.
He's playing this perfect.
And he's back, and he's going to be in Orlando again.
Is he gonna run another rack here?
It looks like it. I mean, look at that stroke. He's really letting it out right now.
Eight ball on the side.
There's a
game one.
Made it look easy.
Now, Kim, you're playing in the International Pool Tour. You'll be playing, obviously, against Mike Sigel, who's going to be on the tour as well.
Yeah, you saw that shot. Huh? I know.
The 150 top players in the world are playing. When they're seeing... And you're watching.
I'm trying to get on the four. I can go across or to six. I figure if I hit the five, it's over. Six, boom, three, right? Well, I hit it good. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, right.
And you played against Mike years ago when he was in stroke. How's he playing now?
Well, other than just a couple of mistakes, which will get better, you know, missing a couple little balls will get better as he plays longer and in time and he gets used to the competition again. It looks like everything's together still. He's still, his rhythm, his pace, his form, everything still looks very good. Tell you what, players watching him play, I'm going to tell you something. They're going to say, hey, They'll be a little nervous when they draw Mike Sigel. Look at that.
No. Ho!
Look at, got the double kiss. Oh.
Yay. Almost scratched real twice. Close. Hey. That would have been his third scratch already on the break in the match.
Watch, it almost gets kissed in twice.
You can see the difference in the breaking capabilities between Mike and Loree Jon.
Yeah, Loree Jon, God bless her, looks like she's throwing a sponge at him when she hits.
Never a doubt. Who said that? How do you like this? Well, I don't think I got a shot. How do you like that? You ever see this before? I'd like stripes, I know that. Gosh almighty. Unbelievable. Well, maybe not. Unbelievable. It's a strange game, isn't it?
You know what he said at the outset, and he reiterated to Mary Strong, he said he was nervous. He's been away from it. This type of competition and this level with this much money at stake.
Actually, I can hit that.
The more he talks to himself, though, obviously, the better he feels.
Play to one.
You can see in the last four games, he's really picked the pace up. I mean, he's
slowed down. Hold on a second here. I can shoot the combination, right, on the three?
Right.
And where's the eight going then? I mean, with the...
Now, this is all just surveying the table because he expects to run the rack.
Four, that's
this is what amateurs don't do. They'll just shoot the easiest ball.
Right.
And he knows, big deal, if I make a ball, am I going to dig myself a grave? Because if he misses a shot with Loree Jon's caliber of play, she can easily just go up there and the game's over. So at this level, you can't miss a ball. You can't miss a shot. Because if you do, you've pretty much given the game to your opponent because they're that good.
Can't make it.
Right, first shot of the rack, too, Kim, is the most important for setting the whole table.
Well, yeah, but if you commit yourself and then make three or four balls and don't get out, then you're pretty much going to lose the game.
Now, he has to have one foot on the floor.
One foot on the floor.
Never seen this before.
Charlie will be watching.
I can't hit it.
Doesn't look like a comfortable position to be in.
He's unbelievable, isn't it?
Shoot it right-handed.
Play to seven.
We've already seen him do that.
Now, why won't he use the bridge? You can't use
seven
the bridge.
In the corner.
He's just not comfortable with
not
the bridge.
Not comfortable with it. He's got to elevate over with the bridge. Bridge is hard enough than elevating over the eight with the bridge. Center cut.
He was right. Who said that?
Well, he's talking so much. Now the gallery's getting involved.
I still don't know what to do here. I don't think I can hit these with the four. That's the problem.
More celebrities are at this event than any other pool event in the history of the game. Pool today is becoming more and more popular than ever. I think that has a lot to do with poker, you know, with the all the interest in poker.
I don't want to move that ball with the eight there. Play to one.
One in the corner.
See, that's his hanger. That's his the one he wanted to save, possibly.
That's the hanger. Now, can he get in position
look out,
here?
Look out.
Do something here. It's unbelievable.
He doesn't like his table at all anymore.
That wasn't a very good shot there.
His leave. You'd think he was down in this match from his body language.
He's always been like that, hasn't he, Kim?
Yeah. He just that's the way he is. That's just his makeup. I mean, you know,
if he's not playing perfect, he's right. Upset with himself.
And he don't get upset with himself too often because he's always playing perfect. So this guy, is he playing safe or is he shooting the six for the combination?
Play safe.
He's playing safe.
Safety.
Just gonna keep the cue ball froze to the three.
Good call.
Did he do it?
Safety allowed.
Well, let's go here. I mean, whoa, was that an easy shot? I mean, please.
Really, he's looking for some reaction here. Who warmed up this crowd?
Somebody clap.
Jeez. I tried to go into him in the sun. Nothing went.
First shot coming up of the second set for Loree Jon Jones. And she had a couple of misses that were just uncharacteristic for her in the first set.
And, of course, Mike just...
Safety.
Safety.
Mike capitalized on those misses early.
Safety allowed.
Now you have to hit your object ball. So she had to hit a stripe and then push it into a rail or the cue ball into a rail, right, Kim? For it to be a legal shot.
Yep. After contact, right? You have to hit a rail, either the cue ball or the object ball.
Otherwise, it would be a foul, and then the opponent gets cue ball in hand anywhere on the table.
Five in the side.
Now she had no shot because Mike played a great safety.
Yeah, the five's on here on the side.
Right, but her safety wasn't very good. She left the shot for Mike.
She left an opening, and he took advantage of it once again.
So that's what you call an unforced error. Or actually, no, that was an error, but Mike put her in a position where she really had nothing to do.
Yeah, she was pretty much handcuffed right there. The eight ball now in this game is still on. Anytime the ball is close to the side pocket by the knuckle, players are a little skittish with it. So he's going to try to break that out with the six, I would imagine.
Hope. Now three.
He went further than he wanted, didn't he?
Right. I think he just wants to roll it up and shoot the six into the side off the eight. I think that's what he's playing for.
Maybe not. Let me look at this.
Looking at the options because, as you mentioned, three. He didn't want to leave it that close.
Three.
Of course, you see.
But
natural,
he's still going to go with the three.
You see naturalcures.com, that's my company, obviously, and that is the main sponsor of the International Pool Tour. I have to put in my little plug there, Joel, every once in a while.
Kevin Trudeau, the founder of the IPT and the World 8 Ball Championship.
I played a six.
Mike Sigel is going to be at the next event, and as he said to Mary Strong, I've got to get ready.
Six in the
because
corner.
He does want to come back and be in competition once again because of what's at stake now all of a sudden.
Well, both of these players will be in all the IPT events. So the next event is for $1 million. And then there's an event next year for $2 million and for $3 million. These players have never played for this much money in their entire careers combined, never mind a one tournament.
You've got that right.
Yeah, so it's
wow.
It's the beginning of a new era in pool.
Really is. And he's elected here not to. God, oh, that wasn't a very good shot at all.
That. Let up on my stroke.
He's come up again. Every time he lifts up, he's made mistakes. When he stays down, he makes no mistake. That's just from not playing for 10 years.
He said he came up on it, though. Did you hear what he said?
Well, yeah.
Came up on my stroke.
Every shot he's come up on, now he's done here.
He's dead.
There's no way. If he makes this, I'll tell you what.
Cloth.
The fans, he might not never quit talking if he makes this shot.
Mr. Sigel must hit the eight ball.
He really don't want to hit it, to be honest with you.
It's ball in hand. If I don't hit the eight.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if he, see, there's the eight ball. He blocked himself. Bad shot.
Rules. It's only cue ball in hand if I don't hit the eight.
Go ahead.
Is that the rule or what? That's you're, you know, trying to pay him.
Maybe he's going to jump over it.
That's Charlie Ursetti, our referee.
Play the eight.
If he doesn't make the eight or if he doesn't hit the eight, Loree Jon has cue ball in hand anywhere on the table.
This is the strategy,
which
though.
He's playing a safety. So it's ball in hand for Loree Jon anywhere on
that's
the
that
table.
Shot. Tried to pop it a little. That's that shot. Look where that ball went forward. If I hit it firm, I get on top of the eight. I had to just kind of pop it over. Whatever, I don't know.
I'll tell you, the next event, those seats are going to be extra money. Because you get to talk to Sigel the entire time. Or have Sigel talk to you.
Will Loree Jon Jones be talking after this rack? And can she roll through it now with the openings that's presented to her?
Well, I know she needs to break the eight out. I would get straight in and bust the eight out here if I was her. It doesn't look like she's going to do that. Maybe it's just not as close as to the rail as I think it is. It looks like it's almost right on it.
Well, maybe you can just kick it into just kiss it into the side.
Right. Well, if she would have got straight in there, she could have drew it back and then hit it and then have the nine in the side. So she had opportunity to do that. Let's see if it comes back and haunts her. Let's see what happens.
Kind of leave does she have?
Oh.
She got away with it, I think. She overstroked it a little bit.
She overstroked that ball.
10 in the corner.
is an easy shot here either, especially being down a set.
She came with it. It was good.
Good touch.
It was a good shot, but she shouldn't have had that shot.
That's her husband, Sammy, in the background. Needs some encouragement right now after losing 9-2 in the opening set.
11 in the corner.
This is not an easy run out here, but she could run this rack and take the game.
Now she's looking to see if the ball goes in the side so she can just roll the cue ball after she makes the ball and be straight in. And it looks like she's going to try to force it out, back off that rail and back and shoot it where she's going to shoot the 11. Shoot those two balls in the same corner. See, this cloth is not allowing her to get back far enough. She just don't have the stroke for that, or is not using it right now.
13.
Well, that's what Mike and a lot of the guys say, that women can be great shot makers, but they don't have the stroke to play on this cloth.
And sometimes I just don't understand. And I see that. How weak that was?
See, yeah.
But why? It's not something that you have to have great strength with. It's really your stroke is not in your arm. It's in your wrist.
See, so now,
not the angle she's looking for.
No.
No, because now she's got no shot here.
If now I was.
Where would you have played that ball?
You mean for position?
Yeah.
I probably would have rolled it up with the 11 and shot the balls on the side. I wouldn't have been there. But now, seeing things, if I was her right here, I would roll the ball up, put the cue ball by the other side pocket, and play safe and leave my ball out by the hole. That's what I would do.
And let Mike give Mike shoot. Give Mike a shot at the 8, but a tough shot where he can't make
it. Oh, very tough. He couldn't bank it, and he can't cut it, so then he would be in trouble. See, she's leaving herself open here.
She's going for the shot, right?
Yeah, but the strategy is not, I don't think this is the right strategy. I really don't.
But she shouldn't be there anyway. She made it.
No.
Oh!
Get out.
Good position for a change.
Well, she played shape for Mike.
Tight as a drum. I cannot loosen.
You could have got better position.
I cannot loosen. I gotta make a ball.
She didn't give herself an easy one to begin with.
No, but she knows.
Mike's dead.
I either see three rails or the bank. I mean, that's all I'm looking at.
She got lucky. She missed the ball, but she saved Mike anyway. Mike doesn't have a shot on the 8.
Yeah, she was trying to get straight in. Huh? So maybe my shot was just as good.
And
why couldn't you land over here? That would have been nice. Well, of course, I could. I like to finesse the 8 and they put the cue ball here. Hang it over there. I like that, but I don't know if I can get there. See, that's the shot.
See, he wants to put the cue ball up here so that she doesn't have a shot on hers.
I know that's the shot, but I can't get the cue ball
into a rail or the cue into a rail. Otherwise,
the ball will stop there. Who knows?
Otherwise, it's a foul.
That's the shot.
He needs to know where that 8's going, too.
Her head. That's the shot. I don't know what's going to happen. Yeah, nap quest here. I don't know.
Now, he has an option. He can try to bank this ball three rails, but that's like a
prayer.
That
is the shot, though. I can see
Jim
that
Rempe,
already.
Hall of Famer,
look at this.
Coming out of retirement to play in the IPT as well.
Nah, you know what? We're in Vegas. I'm just going to gamble.
Okay, go for it, Mike. Crowd likes it, too.
I'm just going to gamble. It's a free shot. I'm playing a three rails in this pocket.
Banking the 8 ball, three rails around the table.
That's
he makes this, you know it's his day.
It's a free shot.
This is, why not? He makes his, what, 1 out of 20?
Probable to go in.
Kim?
Right? Yeah, maybe 1 out of 15.
Okay.
Something like that.
In this pressure, 1 out of 50?
Maybe. You're right, yeah. Because it doesn't look like he can do anything.
He's trying
with
to do three rails here all the way down here. We'll see what happens.
It'll be close.
1, 2.
Oh, way too high.
No.
By
a mile.
Yeah.
That's not even close there.
You got that right. It wasn't.
Tried to pop
that
it
wasn't
down
close
a
at all.
Well, that wasn't close. Well, I would like
14
to
in the corner.
These are actually pretty.
I wish I could have got down another 3-4 inches.
These are well-schooled fans.
Well, this isn't
because they didn't applaud because he missed some.
Right. I mean, he
you can't like that, what Loree just said, because she's not going into this shot with a great mindset to begin with when she just said, this is not as easy as this looks.
Oh, this is an easy shot she has here.
This is a tough shot right here.
This is not easy at all.
It's not automatic.
Just to watch out for the scratch.
Oh, baby.
Good play.
That was a tough shot. And she got right on. But, you know, she put herself on the rail.
Eight in the side.
She's on the rail, which makes this a lot tougher than people know. Because she's right on the rail here.
Pro players do not like to be on the rail with a cue ball.
This for game number one.
I can't do it. I can't stand it. I can't. Oh, I need to just die right now. I'm dying.
Eight in the corner.
Nerves, Kim.
Oh, I'm just
it has
tight
to be.
As a
that's
drum.
What she keeps saying, tight as a drum. Nerves. That's all it is.
Wow. Game two, Mr. Sigel.
Michael, take it. That was a gift. Ooh, absolute gift from that young lady.
There's pressure. Nothing is unbelievable in this game. I can tell you that right now. I've seen
see,
half. I mean, look at that. I got the over the eight. I can't even make the one. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just, stuff happens in this game that it's just. I'm telling you. It's unbelievable.
I'm trying. You know what's sad is I'm trying. God.
Pressure, I'm telling you. They started putting 10 million first place in this. They'll have to play race to one.
Yeah, really.
8 million chances.
Well, the pressure.
Unbelievable.
And Mike alluded to that. It's obviously impacting Loree Jon Jones a lot more than Mike Sigel at this juncture.
Well, I think in these games, whether it's the PGA, whether it's basketball or football or baseball.
What's going on?
You know, you're talking about the amazing pressure that these players are under. They're all spectacular players. It's almost which one is going to succumb to the pressure, and the one that doesn't wins.
Pretty much, you're right.
And nobody wants to use the C word. Nobody wants to talk about the word choke.
Right.
But that's basically what it is, if you think about it.
I might like
I mean,
this.
Really, to be honest with you, that's just, you know. Well, the balls are opening up good for Mike now.
Yeah, he really opened up the table with that break.
Yeah.
He's already taken the first set. Now he's got a 1-0 lead in the second set.
Play to one.
Must taste like castor oil, that water right now, for Loree Jon Jones.
Right. Seems to be a common thing, Mike. Play the one. Play the one. Like he's going to shoot a combination.
And actually, it's 2-0, don't forget. As I just mentioned, one, it's actually two. That's a nice leave off the combination.
Three ball.
Again, for pool, and again, we talk about the pressure. Yeah, the money. It's the biggest money they've ever played for in their life, yes. But we're also talking about the fact that this is probably one of the biggest arenas they've ever played in. More cameras, more television exposure. The Hollywood celebrity party last night these players were at, they were overwhelmed with the red carpetry, but they've been treated like pool players have never been treated before, celebrities.
And as we've already seen on the broadcast, we've seen some of our handheld cameras within inches of both players while they're over the ball. And who is going to succumb to that? And who is going to feel the effects of that? Well, Mike Sigel has not felt it at all. Once he got into the middle of the first set, all of a sudden, he was chirping away. He sounded, as Kim, you've been around him a lot, he sounded like the old Mike Sigel.
Oh, without a doubt. And early, Loree Jon was right in her interview. She said, he's given me all kinds of chances. It wasn't until
the
eighth game, I believe, of the first set where Mike ran out.
The last three games.
Yeah, she had plenty of chances to win. And it looks like now Mike is just, like, really putting in an overdrive.
Five in the side.
Does he get position?
Yeah, once again, he's found a cadence, the way he's marching around the table.
Right. Yeah, he's going right after now. There isn't much stalling around anymore.
Eight ball on the side. Yeah.
He's starting to look like Fast Eddie Felsen in the movie The Hustler against Jackie Gleason, Minnesota Fats.
Good movie.
Game three.
There you go. First three belonging to Mike Sigel.
He just controlled that game. He just walked around and he played perfect pool that game. Didn't have to think.
Like I knew what I was doing that rack. Well, I had a good run out. I mean, you know how many times you don't have a good run out? That's the thing. I'm ready for you now? I'm only inside pockets.
Paul Sorvino giving him some grief in the background.
You're getting a great player, Paul.
guess.
Great player. He had last year. He had the Cervino
Asthma
Foundation.
Four of set two. Mr. Sigel leads 3-0.
He's the founder of the Cervino Asthma Foundation. He had a celebrity charity event last year. I played in with Mike against Loree Jon and the late Jerry Orbach. And Loree Jon never missed a ball the entire tournament. She won. They beat us.
There wasn't this type of prize money at stake, though.
No, and that's the thing.
Oh.
I was under the pressure and missed an easy hanger.
Where's the clap?
She wasn't under any pressure, never missed a ball. And I think the pressure is what the difference is.
Look, the balls have opened up really nice for Mike now. This is maybe the best break of the whole tournament so far. I mean, they're just wide open.
And do you also feel, Kim, that he's now getting a feel for the speed of the table and the slower surface?
Oh, well, there's no doubt. See, that just comes with the confidence. And when he ran those three racks, you know, that was just sending a signal, basically, not only to Loree Jon, but every player in the world. Look, hey, I'm the greatest living player voted, which is what he should have been.
By
and now
peers,
he's
yeah,
back.
But, yeah, by his peers voted that, too.
So, you know, this is really going to do a lot for his confidence.
In the corner.
I'll tell you that. Look how solid he's sitting.
Ball in
the cue
corner.
Ball's not floating a lot. It's just boom, center pocket, boom, center pocket.
Making it look way too easy. He's trying to go up 4-0 in set number two. It's best 2 out of 3. $150,000 to the winner. $75,000. Not too shabby. For the one who comes in second here.
He looks confident, Kim.
Oh, it is amazing. And the thing about Mike, look at this. The thing about him,
look at him move that ball.
Right. When he was playing, you know, at his best, he could still, when he was not playing at his best, he could still be the best. That was how good he used to play.
Corner.
Boy, this is a layup. Mike Sigel and a 4-0 lead.
That was just two. Bam, 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 bam.
Great stuff there.
I'll tell you what, you're starting to see.
Got a little loose here. I mean, you know, a little loose here. 10 years.
He looks loose. Well, put it this way, his lips have been loose the whole match.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what you're watching now is you're watching, in effect, perfect pool.
I do okay on that one?
Huh? Nice smile.
Who's insecure here? His wife.
Get loose.
Getting excited about the prospects.
Game 5 of set 2.
And let's remind everybody that $150,000 for one win, that's a good year's earning in the old days on the tour.
Are you kidding me?
That was big money.
This is phenomenal. What the IBT Tour and Kevin
something
here.
Going,
I mean,
all right.
The players all around the
what?
Country.
Ooh, you dirty rat.
Uh-oh. That should be his favorite saying,
doesn't make
you dirty
a ball
rat.
Here.
Yeah, he comes up empty for a rare occasion.
About 4 of them tried to go in.
You thought he'd get that stripe on the side.
But the players around the world are doing nothing but practicing, playing 8-ball, playing on slow cloth. I mean, everybody's going to be ready. If you're not on your game, you're going to just miss out, I'll tell you that.
And it's in recent years, let's face it, everybody's been conditioned to get ready for 9-ball on a fast track.
And this is a totally different game. Now, it was an open table. She got to choose stripes or solids. And on the first time you're making that selection, you can hit the other ball, which she did,
14.
Into your object ball.
Correct. So you just spin this out 2 rails. Hit it with authority, Loree Jon.
Yeah, she needs a pick-me-up right now, trailing 4-0.
12-ball.
Yeah, I mentioned earlier at the start of the event, we had to turn away hundreds of people at the door. It's standing room only here at Mandalay Bay. It's probably the best venue ever in the history of pool anywhere in the world for this tournament. And this is just the start. The International Pool Tour is launching. This is the inaugural first tournament, the IPT World 8-Ball Championship. And you're going to be seeing millions and millions and millions of dollars of prize money given away now. And you're going to see the best pool ever played. Because, Kim, as you know, because of the prize money, players are now practicing for the first time.
Practicing hard too, and what you're going to see some players that you've never even heard of, from maybe some country you might not ever heard of.
Corner.
you know, and who is this guy? How did he do that? How good is it? You know, so everybody, like I said, everybody's getting really excited.
Loree Jon can run this rack.
Between the ears, she needs to run this rack.
Well, you know, she's down four games in the second set. She's going to win the set. Otherwise, it's over.
10-ball in the corner.
But she is probably one of the best comeback players of all time. You know, we've seen what happened in recent years with the Red Sox and the Yankees and everything else. So, did she make this? Yeah.
Good shot.
Nice lead.
Beautiful. Great shot.
Well, this finally break the ice for Loree Jon Jones.
She needs to just draw. Oh, she has to use the crutch here.
And if she gets this game, she gets the break back, which is a huge advantage because she has the ability to break and run out, break and run out, break and run out, and win four, five, six games in a row.
She's 11 in the corner.
She's done it so many times in the past.
Oh.
Yeah, a little bit close. As you can see,
8-ball in the corner.
But she's got a good angle on the 8-ball.
Yeah, but players don't want to get nowhere near where the cue ball has to, you know, they have to elevate their cue or about hitting it.
I thought she had to jack up over the ball.
Yeah, this could throw her off just a little bit, but I think she'll make it.
For the game, for the game, for the game!
Yes! Oh. Finally!
Shake it!
That was a good run out.
It really was.
Oh, I got out.
She's smiling about it.
That was a good run out.
I will.
Yeah, relief now. And as you mentioned, she gets to break. Let's see if it can start. The kind of run we saw from Mike Sigel when he had three consecutive racks.
So important right now to make a ball on the break, and then you have a chance to run out, and Mike can just sit there for the next half an hour.
Yeah, she needs to look at that.
She made a ball.
All right.
And it looks like a pretty
scratched.
She really did.
Pretty good table, though, for her, opened up, too.
She got a real good break.
Yeah, she almost scratched there. And you're right, Joel. The balls are pretty much all spread out.
That is truly one of her best breaks we've seen.
Yep.
Okay. This is her chance to get going.
So can she take advantage? It's wide open, surveying what she wants to do. And as we mentioned before, it's with a mindset, and she'll go with stripes.
Yeah, she's making the right choice here. She has another little combination down there, but that shouldn't be no problem. It looks like it's almost straight.
12 in the corner.
Well, she's looking like she's just picking up the pace a little bit too. She might need to do that and not think so much about what she's doing. Just do it as a natural thing.
Combination 14-13 in the corner.
Cue ball, just make the 14 come back, slide off the rail.
Perfect.
Well done. And she should have two automatics at that end of the table.
10-ball in the corner.
And she's got a couple throw-ins there.
Good kiss.
Yeah, but she really did. She's okay, but she should have just kept the cue ball a little underneath the ball.
Yeah,
but she's picked the pace up to her credit. It's very good, and it's showing that she's playing a little better.
She's a little too straight than she wants, right?
Yeah. She needs to make sure and stroke it.
Now she has to draw back, see?
9-ball on the side.
She did perfectly well, but again, that looks so easy for her at her level of play, but at home, try to do that on a slow nap cloth. The ball doesn't move.
You're exactly
she
right.
Moved it 6 feet. It's a great shot.
8-ball in the corner.
She just ran the last game, Kim. She just ran out on the last game.
Love being over these balls.
Never missed a ball. She could.
That's right.
She gave herself a tough one. She's going to jack up here, but this could be a break and run out for Loree Jon.
Tough shot, elevated.
To run the rack and draw within 4-2.
Oh! Thank you.
Just enough.
That's 2 inches.
That's the first time she's run a rack today.
That's right. Well, tell you what, she can break and run the next five.
Look at this. 1, 2, 3, in. Wow.
Oh, look at this.
Wow. 7. Oh. I will.
Just on that last rotation.
They're going in now.
She just won the. She just ran. Mike just sat.
7 more.
She just sat. Mike sat there for the last two games.
Oh, wouldn't that be sweet? 7 and out.
She can run the next 7 racks.
She can.
Don't laugh. I can do it.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, yeah. Get into it, Laurie. Let them know.
I can play. I can play. I've been a little nervous, though. But I'm going to show up.
This is game seven. Ms. Jones trails 4-2.
I'll tell you who's nervous now, Mike Sigel. Because he knows she can run the next seven.
What if she breaks and runs out here? He'll really get nervous. She's got chances now. The balls are falling in.
Yep. That was a good break for her.
Mike's over there. Mike's not saying nothing much.
The mouth is quiet.
The mouth is quiet. That's how you make him be quiet. Keep him parked in that chair.
As Loree Jon Jones said, I love being over these balls. Finally, she's out of her chair.
Yeah. Look at this.
Can't do much when you're sitting in the corner.
I'm not. Don't say anything yet. I'm just looking.
Talking to Charlie Urzetti, the referee, because she has not made a decision yet.
I thought she was talking to Mike.
Now Mike is.
This is the quietest Mike has been the entire match.
Yeah, he used to be called Captain Hook because he was famous for hooking people or snookering them or not giving them a shot. But because he talks nonstop, he's been dubbed the Mouth by his peers. So he's Mike the Mouth. Sigel, rightly named, I think.
And when you're a world champion like he has been, and you guys mentioned, voted the world's greatest living player, he's won 6 U.S. Opens, 5 world titles. Usually you're up and you can chirp a little bit because you control the table.
That's exactly right.
2-ball.
2-ball.
Well, this sets everything up. If this is the go shot. If she makes this, she's playing well enough where she should run this table. Key shot.
Tough shot. Nope.
Oh.
No. Time up.
That was tough. She had to play position. She was playing English. That was really difficult. That's just a tough shot.
It is a tough shot. But she missed it pretty good ways, but.
Yeah.
So it's back to Mike Sigel. In game seven, a 4-2 lead at this juncture.
Now, Mike's been sitting there for a couple games, so he could be a little tight. And this is not an easy table to run out.
I keep waiting for him to say something. He hadn't said nothing in like 2 minutes.
We have been talking about what a great pool player Paul Sorvino is. Now let's meet a great actor with Claudia Jordan.
Okay, Paul Sorvino, now tonight is the biggest night in pool as far as winnings go. What do you think this exposure is going to do to the sport?
If it does what I hope it will do, it will jump it up, because this is there's never been prize money like this in the history of pool. In England, they play a game of billiards called snooker.
Mm-hmm.
The men make huge amount. They play for $1.5 million, $2 million, $3 million in one tournament. The women get nothing. That's why the women came over here to play night ball. When the stakes like this are up this high, people will start to watch. It takes great skill to play this game, as you can see. As soon as they get into it, because of the high stakes, it should do a great deal for the game, which I'd like to see.
I hope so, too.
Over in the corner.
Sigel.
Ooh, now, again, people don't know just how tough Mike, I mean, how tough a shot that was, but to get in the proper position so that he could put the cue ball into those 2 balls and break them up so he can continue to running the rack, that's a skill that people just can't comprehend at the amateur level.
Right, and Kevin, not only hit the ball to break him up, but hit it on the right side to break it up.
You're talking about a half an inch.
10 and a quarter.
Being able to put the ball pretty much where you want within a half an inch.
Correct.
9.
Coming over on the combination.
Combination, 13 into the 9.
Now, this is a dangerous shot. When you make that combination, where the balls are going, you don't know.
He should just shoot it fairly easy so the 13 will stay.
Oh, he gets
win.
A boat.
Well, okay, well,
2-for-1. 13, he'll take
2
it.
2-for-1, yeah.
14 to the side.
Now he has to be careful here. Just draw it straight back. Wants to make sure and draw it back far enough. Yeah, he's
8 in the corner.
Everything's rolling well for Mike now. You can see he's not coming up short on his position. The stroke's
that's
out.
I
can play a little too, you know.
Yep, he can play.
I can play a little.
Yeah, he can play.
We already know that.
I play a little. I can play a little.
Huh? You're supposed to because you say you're a man.
What? Starting to banter me now? That's not nice. It's not nice. I'm a gentleman. My hand's got a cramp in it. What do I do there?
No sympathy right there from Loree Jon Jones.
He said a four and out.
What did he say, four and out? Is that what Mike said?
He said he's going to run four and out.
Well.
He sounds like Muhammad Ali now, going to knock somebody out in the fifth round.
This is game eight.
Don't forget, that's what he did in set number one. Once he got up 5-2. He took the last four with 3 consecutive racks after he was up 6-2. Is this?
Oh, come on. What is this?
Do you believe it?
Oh, I made the eight.
That's
yes,
a win.
There you go.
Everybody's
done.
Everybody's
done. That's a win. That's the rule. At eight sinks off the break, you win.
You win the game.
Come right up the back rail, kissed it right in the side.
Look at this. Look at this.
Look
here
at the cue ball, too, now.
Here it comes. Boom.
8 cue ball. The cue ball almost goes, too. That
Again,
was amazing.
In the professionals, this happens so rare, you shouldn't be penalized by making the eight ball.
There you go.
So.
There you go. There you go.
That doesn't happen now, very often at all.
There we go.
How demoralizing.
There we go.
Loree Jon Jones.
There we go. Now we're cooking.
I'll tell you what.
How
might
can
not
the ball
again.
Not go in to make two every time? I hit those pretty good, didn't I? No, I hit those not too bad. Do 7 times in a row, do that. That's only happened 3 times in 6 weeks of me playing. That's how tough that is.
Game
I like
nine.
3 more times.
Mr. Sigel leads 6 games to 2.
3 more is all he needs, but he'll take 4.
His 2 friends in there, Nick Varner, Hall of Famer, and Jim Rempe, Hall of Famer, both pretty much haven't been playing in a long time. Rempe, not at all.
Ah! I made 1, made 2. Oh, give me a shot. Ho! Me hit something.
And both of those Hall of Famers are now playing on the International Pool Tour against all the young guns who think that they... don't have a chance. It's going to be very interesting to see for the tour, Joel. The older Hall of Famers coming out of retirement, players from Australia, New Zealand, Croatia, Moscow, all over the world, who the American players have never seen. The UK snooker champions are coming over. The top 150 players in the world, young guys, also the women are playing.
4 in the corner.
For millions of dollars, it's really the most exciting thing pool has ever seen.
And will the experience of a Mike Sigel pay off? Or will the young guns, as you mentioned, not be intimidated at all because of the level of play they're accustomed to?
5
or
in
the
side.
Snooker players in the UK or the guys in Australia who play 8-ball all the time?
Well, I think experience will show up on this tour. I really do, because playing 9-ball, it's just a shooter's game.
I don't know.
And a wide-open table.
When you're playing 8-ball, you have to think. You have to use your noggin. You have to have some knowledge, everything like that. So I really think that players like...
Play to 3.
Sigel.
3 in the corner.
That's a good point, because Barner, you have to set up shots way down the road.
Right. Hopefully Davenport.
That's right. Airplane in that tour.
Yeah, you are going to be there.
Ho.
With bells on.
6 in the corner.
7 in the side I was playing for.
It's the voice of Kim Davenport, former world number one, who's going to be at the million-dollar tournament in Orlando with Mike Sigel and so many others.
Make it tough.
Loree Jon is sitting in that chair.
Make it tough.
Mike
Six
has
the
break. If he runs us out, he breaks again.
She may never get out of that chair.
She may.
I'll tell you what.
Mike is loosened up
here. 2-ball.
2 in the corner.
He ain't missing a ball.
She in pool at his best right now.
You're seeing perfect pool right now. You're seeing a guy who is in stroke, who's got confidence, who knows what he's doing. He's been there before, over 100 tournament wins.
And hadn't played in 10 years competitively.
I'll play it.
Winningest player of all time.
He'll never be out of shape the way he talks and walks.
You should see the way he eats, though.
Does he make it?
Unbelievable.
Oh, look at this.
You like that finish?
Oh, baby.
I like the body action.
Right-handed.
About to go up. 7-2. What a command performance.
This is unbelievable. He's going for the 8-ball for the game, right-handed, and he's a lefty.
Offhand. How about that?
That's unbelievable.
What is that?
That's unbelievable.
That's a bitter pill
for the ball. Look at him. Impossible.
Bitter pill for her to swallow.
That really is.
I'm going to shoot my tongue next time.
Look at him.
Boy, this is, I can't just get, I mean, it's always something, always, always something.
Cup's always empty.
He's jarring, always he's, what something. Is up, 6-2? Is it 7-2?
7-2
now. 7-2, and he's always jarring.
7-2. I want some of that coffee he's drinking.
I'm saying, what is
it? I think she sees the writing on the wall.
She really might not get back to the table.
I mean, what is this?
It was 4-2, don't forget. It looked like Loree Jon Jones was going to get back into
the
match.
10, boy. The Sigel lead.
Yeah, she missed the little
7-2.
Well, she missed that 8 ball.
And plus the 2 ball she missed.
And that was the last ball she shot, the 2 ball. Then Mike runs the rack, then hits the 8 ball on the break, breaks and runs out that rack. Here he goes again.
Oh, he's hitting him solid. Look at that. Look how solid he's hitting him.
Give me a shot.
He's got a couple go down.
Hole 12. Whoa. Go.
Ho or whoa?
Do something.
Do something. He
said, make up your
mind,
Mike.
Do something. Just want a shot.
Oh, Mike.
Folks, for those who you're watching, Mike Sigel voted the greatest living player. And you are watching him play probably the best pool that you will ever see on television by a pool player.
It's unbelievable here.
It's really...
It's
getting to the point, Kim, where it's kind of like Sandy Koufax throwing a perfect game in the World Series.
Yeah, yeah, it is amazing, I'll tell you. When I used to play this guy, Mike, I would always get to smell the gravy and he'd get to eat the meat. I mean, it was like, come on, you know. Mike, will you stop it? He is.
And you still like him.
Oh, yeah, sure. We're good friends. We go to dinner, this and that. But he might not be a good friend after this. I'm going to have to be my competitor, you know what I mean? No, he's a hell of a guy, Mike. He just happens to be, you know, one of the greatest pool players, if not the greatest pool player of all times.
Slow down.
And you know,
I gotta get over here.
A lot of players, you know, Rempe, Varner, and so forth, and you know them all.
I played
it too. They traveled around making most of their money, not in tournaments, but, quote, hustling.
Side action.
Yeah, I mean, you know, because there's just no real money out there in the tournaments. So, and now, you know, the IPT, I mean, here we are.
Six in the corner.
This is really something, and everybody's excited, Kevin, about it. And look at Mike. It looks like Mike's never left.
This is unbelievable what he's doing right here.
I mean, just everything's perfect.
Something here. And a freeze.
He's straight in every shot.
You would think from listening to him, especially over the last few shots, that he's down in this match.
Yeah, and he's not playing right. Because he's, you know why he's upset? He's off by a half an inch.
Yeah, he is a perfectionist.
Freeze. Freeze.
Oh, he
doesn't want the rail. He got too close.
He's an inch too far, and he's upset.
He made a shot on me one time. It was a great shot.
Unbelievable.
Comes back, says, Mr. N, when he sits down at the table. I says, what's that? It's for knowledge. I said, Mike, it starts with a K. It's been a running joke with us ever since, 20 years ago.
The grammarian that he is.
Matter of fact, on my cell phone, oh. Mr. N.
Three in the corner.
Yeah, look at it.
Is he going to roll through this rack the same way?
The way he's playing right now, you could run a freight train through this building. He's not going to miss no shots. It is pure delight to watch this. Not for Loree Jon, but look at that. Everything's
now
moving.
He played that with corner. The English on that ball. You just people at home have no idea. He played that with low left.
Yeah, and it was so pure. I mean, it just came out perfect.
With perfect speed.
This to go up 8-2, does it again.
Game, Mr. Sigel.
Look at him.
Retired. Yeah, retired. He's been
the man.
Every
I'm
day.
The man. Tell him. Freeze. I don't care now. Just get under the rail. I don't care.
You know,
make it like impossible every shot. I don't care. What's the difference?
He's on the hill.
Everything's froze. I mean, I got to hit every, you know what I mean? I don't care anymore.
He really does. As good as he's
I'm beyond that. It's unbelievable. I mean, I can't get off the rail an inch. You know?
Loree Jon can't even dislike like this
inch.
Guy.
Be real easy.
You're watching pool history, folks. The international
this is
pool
game
tour
11.
Launched.
Mr. Sigel leads 8-2.
Big gulp by his wife because he's a game away from $150,000, the largest payday and the biggest check he'll ever collect.
He's
in
on
pool.
The hill right here. This is the game.
He said he was going to run four and out, didn't he?
That's yes. Right. That's what he said. Sounds like Muhammad Ali here.
Really does.
Will he sink one off the break? Hard to believe he didn't.
Ooh.
That's a rarity.
Right.
Now she's getting.
Oh, you like it. Oh, you like it. Oh, now.
Well, she has to dig deep now, I'll tell you. She cannot.
She can't miss
can't
a ball.
She can't miss no more. It's absolutely
she
over if
she misses
any
ball.
More.
You know, Ray Martin made a great statement, a Hall of Famer, said, I watch a person play for 2 hours. If they miss one ball or more, I know I can beat them.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Great. And that's really what happens when you're at this level. If you miss one ball, just one, the other person gets up, runs out, you may never get a chance to go to the table.
Right. And to Loree Jon's credit, I mean, she really hasn't played the way she knows how to play, but she's one of the all-time great women players. I mean, all time.
Eight-time world champion in the Hall of Fame, youngest player at 15 to win a championship.
And maybe the most beloved female player of all time.
And it just reminds us of the level, and Kevin, you've alluded to it over the last three games in particular, the level that Mike Sigel is playing at today.
Two ball in a corner.
At times, though, Loree Jon Jones has been her own worst enemy, and she's admitted it, saying, I'm tight as a drum and just not really able to get into a rhythm, a flow in this match.
She was not been able to get in no rhythm at all, and that's a shame. But, you know, she'll learn from this.
Well, she certainly hasn't played her best, no question. But at what you're seeing Mike Sigel do,
intimidation factor, well, believe me.
It almost doesn't matter how good she did play or who Mike was playing at this point, because the way Mike is playing right now, it almost doesn't matter.
Right.
Mike is just pitching a perfect game in the World Series. I mean, you're watching perfect pool on Mike Sigel's part.
Well, she's thinking too long again. She needs to just get up there and shoot the balls, because she had a nice little thing going when she was up there, not really looking at everything, taking a lot of time just shooting, getting in a flow.
Three ball in the corner.
And she won two games in a row. At that point, it was 4-2 Sigel.
It looked like she was getting the rhythm. It's the IPT, International Pool Tour World 8-Ball Championship, biggest prize money in the history of the sport.
She pulled it
back
too much.
Corner.
Well, indeed, if Mike does win this, I'm going to have him take me out to dinner. Big dinner. Oh, very nice shot. She made a good shot, but now she's over the ball. That's why an 8-ball, you have to be so precise, because there's so many other balls around you.
Gosh.
And if you make one little mistake, like look here, how is she going to get back on this 6 now?
She's got to get on top of it, so all of a sudden it's the bridge.
You know, her best shot would be, if you can see the little gap in between the 12 and the 11, just shoot it, make the 7, and just come out, shoot the 6 in the side.
And this is where the European players seem to have an advantage over Americans, because they're more used in snooker. They use that bridge a lot more often and are much more proficient at it.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt. Make the ball. That's the first order of business.
Position.
Six ball.
She get out far enough?
Nope.
No, I didn't think so. Yeah, that would have been it. Yeah. I didn't think that was the right play there, but maybe she thought she could sneak out there. I tell you what, her competitive fire really bubbles near the surface. Them eyes of hers, I mean, it's just woo.
Well, here's what she's thinking. She's got one ball to go, then the 8. She misses this ball, Sigel runs out, it's over.
Right.
Kind of typifies her day, though.
She can't miss a ball. And here she goes. She's trying to swerve this again?
She's
like
not
the third time she's trying to have a swerve a ball.
And she's not had enough curve either time. Let's see if she at least gets enough curve this time.
Almost. Well, three times in this match,
I know I did.
Loree Jon has had to hit down in the cue ball, swerve it around balls, and three times she's came up close. But not close to
look at that there.
It's just hanging.
Oh.
I'm going to go out on a limb, and I'm going to predict that Mike's going to run this rack out.
Well,
I don't think anybody's going to bet against you.
The way Mike has been playing, I mean, he probably would have ran the rack if he made a ball on the break.
He could turn the cue around the other end and run out. I'm telling you,
he's playing
that
right now.
It goes back to what you just mentioned.
14
One miss can beat a guy, the best players in the world. Well, Loree Jon Jones has had 4 or 5 misses in this match today.
Wow.
Gets a break on a tight pocket.
Another tough
grand here, for God's sake.
Tough shot, but he makes it.
Nice little tough shot, little jerk of the pants. Run some more racks. He's going to be thrilled, I'm sure. And that's assuming that he runs out this game. But when you're playing that good, you really wish that it could go on. I want to keep playing when I'm playing that well.
Well, he has a tough run out. This is not easy. He has to do really
in the corner.
Some really important things here to run this rack and win the championship. But he also knows if he misses, then Loree Jon goes up and gets the break back, and she can easily run seven racks in a row. He knows that. So he does not want to let Loree Jon back to the table.
Oh, no doubt about it. The pressure's still on. He has to execute, but it's almost like, say, there for the taking. So.
Well, and he's got a dominating 8-2 lead. So
11 in the corner.
The way he's marching around the table, his body language tells you he's going to finish things up. If not this game, eventually in this second set. And it's the best 2 of 3. But looking down the road, what this could do for him mindset-wise, before he gets to Orlando, to have this under his belt and to play at this high a level.
This is the shot here.
Does he get in position? That's
it right there. He's now just stop, and it looks real good. He's breathing kind of deep.
12 in the corner.
Brings it back perfectly.
Unbelievable. We watched him play the last hour. I mean, it's just phenomenal how good he played.
He hasn't missed the ball.
Great touch.
Hold on.
He don't want to overamp, you know.
Well, he knows this is for the money. I mean, he's went two more balls for the 8-ball champion, world champ for the world title.
And $150,000. That is quite some championship here.
Graze it. That's what I wanted.
8-ball in the
corner. Yes. Oh, that's what I wanted. The little nudge.
He got it. He got that little kiss and nudge.
This is for game, set, and
tough pill to swallow. So tough for Loree Jon Jones. Yeah. She's not in this position very often.
Mike's the greatest player in the world.
No doubt.
This for the championship.
I'm the man.
He's got it.
I'm the man. I can't believe I won this.
After 10 years.
That was good stuff there.
Kevin, I know you have to get to the floor. Thank you for your help.
I'm going
to
give them the money.
What an event.
Down to the floor.
All right. Thanks, Kevin Trudeau.
I don't believe it. I really don't. I don't believe it. Huh? Thank you very much. I don't believe it.
Yeah, tough one for Loree Jon Jones, as I mentioned.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I can't believe I won. I'm telling you right now.
Just to make it official, sign the score sheets, please.
He honestly can't believe, I don't think.
Denmark.
Mike. Yeah, to make it official now.
That's the end of the second set with the final score.
Making it official.
Mrs. Jones,
the cards.
Mr. Sigel wins the first two sets and the championship.
You never see Loree Jon Jones dismantled quite like that. But
winning the International
Mike Sigel was
first ever
perfect play all day.
Championship. Now, audience, please remain seated for the presentation of the awards, including
Kim, we saw a world champion at his very best today.
Cash first
we really
prize.
Did.
Well, he's still in disbelief. Once you see what Kevin Trudeau is about to present, you'll believe it, Mike Sigel.
No, never. This set, I played this set like perfect.
He's still talking.
And he really didn't. Involve the referee as Charlie Orsetti makes his way. Because now, the biggest payday in the history of the sport belongs to one of the great champions we have ever seen. Vote of the world's greatest living player. He's done it all. And today, he picks up the largest payday he has ever seen. Let's head downstairs now for the presentation with Mary Strong.
Larry, how do you like this?
Loree Jon, disappointing loss, but what an exciting match. I know you were feeling the pressure before the match started. Do you think nerves played a part in some of the choices you made tonight?
Absolutely. I would love to play a match over again like this and just get my stroke back, you know, just get my thoughts back and everything else because I just couldn't loosen up. I have never been this nervous, I don't think, in my life. Mike knows. Thank you.
Well, you're not leaving empty-handed. You're taking home $75,000, and I'm sure this isn't the last time we're going to see you on the International Pool Tour. Am I correct?
No, it's not, because I definitely want another match with Mike Sigel, because I need to get back on here again.
We've got a rematch, I think. Well, we look forward to it, Loree Jon. And Mike, congratulations. You are the first world champion on the International Pool Tour and the winner of the largest prize in pool history, $150,000. I'm sure it hasn't even sunk in yet.
It's unbelievable. Now we both wanted to win this, and
you're doing great.
What we did was great, but I mean, this whole thing is due to Kevin Trudeau. I wish he would come out here, really.
Come on up here, Kevin. To present the grand prize is the founder of the International Pool Tour, Mr. Kevin Trudeau.
Oh, I hope you have a bet fight.
It's okay.
Yeah, I know. I'm just like, can you believe it?
What a match. What a match. What do you think? What a match. Two great champions. Two great champions. First, Loree Jon, it was obviously this probably more pressure than any pool tournament in history.
Than ever.
And the biggest prize money, and this is just the start of a new era,
the
golden era in
pool. Thanks to you. Thank you, Kevin Trudeau. Yeah. And thank you.
Thank you. Not a bad consolation prize.
No, not a bad.
I have a check here for $75,000.
Thank you.
To Loree Jon Jones. Great, great champion. And it's tough when you get up against Mike and he plays like he played today.
I'll tell you, he played great, great. Second match towards the end, that was Mike Sigel.
I was just talking to Paul Servina, and he said that was perfect pool.
It
was. It's tough to beat when someone's playing perfect pool.
It was.
But thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Well done.
Thank
you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Loree Jon Jones. Many people have said this man is probably the greatest player in pool history, and today we saw, I think, an exhibition. As was said here, while talking with some of the folks, we just saw somebody play perfect pool. It was like a no-hitter in baseball. When you come up against that, it's hard to beat. But folks, the first IPT 8-ball world champion, Mr. Mike Sigel.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. The biggest trophy in pool history. And the biggest prize fund, $150,000.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, as we found out, Mike Sigel, a tough guy on the outside, but a softy on the inside as he celebrates with his wife. And for Kevin Trudeau, Kim Davenport, I'm Joel Myers. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Mike Sigel, the champion, the world 8-ball champion of the International Pool Tour. So long, everybody.